All right, so I forgot to say something about exponential growth or the exponential model. I'm actually an ecologist that doesn't work much with population growth and population modeling, but I work a lot with exponential models. And the way that I work with exponential models is looking at exponential decay. So I study leaf litter decomposition, and I need to calculate a decomposition rate, which is just like a population growth rate, but a little bit different because it's negative. So here's a good example of exponential model that's applied to decomposition, which, sorry, I guess it should go this way, decreasing through time, right? Kind of an upside down J. And the exponential decay model looks like this. So the weight of, say, a leaf litter, because I look at leaf litter decomposition, at some time in the future, W sub T can be modeled or predicted based on the initial weight times e to the negative kt. So see how similar that is to the exponential growth model, except that instead of e to the rt, it's e to the negative kt. And the negative k gives us the decomposition, the decay, the negative part. And the k is called the decomposition rate. So when I'm looking at, when I'm interested in looking at leaf litter decomposition, I use the exponential decay model to calculate the decomposition.